Hi, my name is Antonis, and I am the iconographer of this video. Today you will see me painting Saint Demetrios, the first part of this icon, and for this I'm using the beautiful icon of the Vatopedi monastery, which is in Mount Athos. As you already see, I have already started by having transferred my drawing on the board, gilded the icon, and now I'm doing this underpainting. This is for this I'm using pure black color, and I'm doing this mainly to avoid etching the gesso, my board, with a needle or the tip of a compass. Many iconographers etch the drawing, the facial characteristics of the saint on directly on the board, and often this injures the gesso, and although it's very helpful later on for the iconographers to see the drawing underneath, often it doesn't look very good, and as I said, it injures the icon. So in this case, and also in all my icons, I try to avoid etching the drawing on the board, and trying to do some basic underpaint. Now, if you notice, most of the times I will just draw with my brush the facial characteristics, like the painting that I'm doing right now. But today, since this icon of Saint Demetrios is a very painterly one, and belongs to the so-called Macedonian style of iconography, I will also do a little bit of underpainting, just to familiarize myself with this face of Saint Demetrios more, to make myself more familiar with the forms, the lights and the shadows on this face. And also because this underpainting will, I believe, will inform my icon in, later on. It will be visible, even though it will be covered by the proplasmos, the basic color of the face. But this is something that you will see and judge by yourselves later on. Probably in the next, or the video after the next, that you will see the second part of the finished icon. So today you see me already having started doing this underpainting. I will, after I paint my facial characteristics, I will start by deciding which shapes, which areas are the darkest. And little by little, I will start shadowing these areas. I will not go directly to dark. I will keep my color transparent. Of course, it's I'm using in this case pure black, but diluted very much, very thinned down with egg solution. For this underpainting, I will not use any white pigment at all. I will just use plain black. So the various values that you see here are achieved by thinning down my color and making it more transparent. So I just play with transparency in order to achieve this. I don't want to add any white there. Just because it will make things heavier, and it will add some pigment for a process that I don't want that I want to keep the icon, the face, more light. If I add some white there, things will become heavier. I know this doesn't seem very clear to you, but I'll just try to build the light and the shadows with the use of transparencies and just one color. So as you see here, little by little, I will cover most of my face with some color there. And I'll try to let's say distribute the shadows as best as I can. I will observe my amazing reference very much, and I'll try to transfer these relationships, the relationships that I see on the face of my reference, to I'll try to transfer those on my icon as well. Little by little, this is something that to me, this is a process that is very satisfying. It's not stressful at all, and I just try to play, and I know that nothing of this will be visible at the end. It will be covered by the color of Plasmos. That liberates me to play a little bit with my brush, with my values, with my material here, and try to see if I can achieve some similarity or some rich values here just by using one color and my brush. This truly is very satisfying, and at the same time, it really does what it's supposed to do, to familiarize myself with the reference icon. I feel that I understand better the value, the shapes, and the areas that later on I will have to keep in light or in shadow. So I just play around, and I already see that this head proceeds in a nice way. Now I'm pretty sure that when I will paint the Proplasmos later on, it will be a little bit, this underpainting will be a little bit visible, since I will paint, it will allow me to use a more transparent maybe Proplasmo, and this will somehow inform and enrich my Proplasmos later on. So if you find this explanation and this content helpful, please like this video and consider subscribing. I want to thank you so much for being here and being part of this community. Sometimes it's very hard for me to respond to your comments. They are too many and too nice, and that's something very rewarding for me. So thank you so much for supporting me. If you want to see more tutorials, you can also support me in patreon.com. You can find me there. And you can find also some material that's exclusively posted in patreon.com. So I have to say that this underpainting is already finished. I will proceed with painting the clothes, as you see here, and I have to say that it was very, very, very satisfying to paint. So it doesn't do any bad to your icon if you just keep it light and simple, as I said, just by using the black color. Try to experiment and play a little bit, see what you can do, and you will definitely feel how helpful it is, and how it will make you feel the icon better later on when you will proceed with painting the Proplasmos, the crapsimata, and the photismata of the icon. So now I've proceeded with filling the proplasmi of the clothes. I will try to paint these clothes as faithful to my reference as I can. And I can already feel that this will be a slightly different process than me painting in the Cretan style. I can already feel that this is a more painterly approach that I should have, and somehow I welcome this change. I can't actually wait to proceed with painting the face with the greenish proplasmos, the greenish base color. And I want to see what kind of results I can achieve with using this and studying this specific icon from the Vatopedi monastery of Mountain Athos. I already see that the way this iconographer paints the clothes is much free. It's much more free than the way a Cretan iconographer would approach these forms. That's very interesting for me, and as I said, very refreshing and rewarding to paint. I feel that I could keep painting the underpainting on the face for a lot more, just because it felt so good, and also because the more I paint, the more I see that there are things to paint. Like I could maybe shadow down a little bit more of the light areas. In general, I feel that I could definitely move on with adding some more darker values there. Now you see me painting the so-called chrysokondylia, the golden decorative lines on his armor. This is a color that I prepare by mixing titanium white with some cadmium yellow, and it's a pretty strong color that sometimes can replace the golden decorations on the armor of a saint. I guess that these in the original icon in Mount Athos are done with real actual gold. Here it's not my purpose to study this technique, so I'll just paint these lines with this beautiful yellow-white color. So I want to thank you again. I hope that you truly are well and creative, healthy and creative. That's, I think, the most important, especially during these hard times. And know that being in the studio truly helps us. At least for me, it's very, very helpful, and it really balances me. I don't know what I would do if I wasn't in the studio. So if you are inspired by these videos to experiment a little bit more and study more these references, that's truly rewarding for me, and I want to thank you so much. Once more, big thank you for your amazing comments. I read them all, I have to say, and sometimes they truly hit their hit in my heart. Thank you again. Be blessed, be creative, be healthy, and I will see you soon with another video tutorial and soon with the second part of this video. Bye.